Please stand clear of the doors.
Hey, guys. Man, I'm getting kind of old. On the monorail. Good thing to have this monorail. Can't wait to go relax at the Tiki Room.
Yeah, I love the update they did on Tiki Room, and now it's 2032.
Yeah, I don't really love that they killed off all the birds and put in the Terminator. I know they bought the rights to...
Zombies anniversary episode.
Oh my gosh, I forgot all about that.
Wow, I forgot all about that too. Alex, how's the history going on that? You find anything yet?
Yeah, I got my reminder a day ago, and you know, even though there's Zombie 18 coming out next month, there's really not a lot of history.
Welcome to episode 164 of the Diz Hiz podcast. I'm Joe.
I'm Alex.
I'm Chris.
Today, we will be giving the Hiz on zombies. Right now, we are recording live for our Goof Troop members. If you want to watch us live, all you got to do is go to DizHiz.com, DizHiz.com, and you will find the link on the very top, as well as seeing our faces. You've been entered into our lovely, lovely giveaways, where we give away signed comics, wax melts, Disney merch, whatever Chris has lying around the house that's giving away. But you will also get access to our Goof Troop chat, and you will be able to interact with us and our other Goof Troop members where we talk Disney daily.
And if you want to share a memory or send us a message, you can call 707-842-0345. That's right. Do not adjust your dials. I said you can call us at 707-842-0345. Or if you know you're of this time, you can email me at DizHizHistory@gmail.com. Send us an email. And actually, I got an email this week, guys. So I'm going to share this email.
Oh my gosh.
I got an email from Benjamin. And he says, hi, listening to the new episode this morning. Wanted to let Alex know that I'll be having some leftover homemade beef tacos for lunch today. Mmm, beef tacos. I love tacos.
Me too.
So do I.
Even better, I love leftover tacos.
Dude, my favorite place to eat at Magic Kingdom? Pecosville.
Where they just give you leftovers?
No, but they give you, but it makes tacos. Right?
I know, yeah. Really good. I love Pecos Bill.
Yeah.
I hope you get 100 of these to savor and read. Unfortunately, you're the only one that sent me information about what you're eating for lunch. Maybe even hit up the teacups after reading them all. Nothing says Fantasyland like writing the teacups with a full stomach. Isn't that right?
Oh, man. Hit it right on the head.
Yeah. And then apparently,
in chat, Pecos Bill is incredible. It really is incredible.
It is incredible. Yeah. And then I guess the episode, I don't remember everything we talked about, but I guess we talked about doing an episode on Thunder Mesa because it says Thunder Mesa is a great idea for an episode. Back in April, my wife and I went to Sedona, Arizona to celebrate our 10-year anniversary. Congratulations. It was awesome to see the real Thunder Mountain that the attraction was based upon. We even drove by where Big Thunder Ranch was, which was used by Disney for a lot of Western filming. Thank you for keeping your show fun, Ben. Hey, Western filming? I bet you they shot some Zorro there.
Yeah, probably right.
Think he's okay?
Who?
Okay.
Zora.
Why? You think he's still there?
Oh, because shooting.
Alex, first of all, we didn't talk about doing Thunder Mesa. You actually, one of the 1,000 suggestions you said for an email, one of them was if you have any ideas for history of a episode. So maybe we will take his,
No, because we did talk about doing history of Thunder Mesa. Because we were talking about the history we're doing. Was Mark Davis, and he had the idea of a ride for Thunder Mesa, and Joe said we should do a history on Thunder Mesa.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, you see. So, also, what's happening, just so people who are not Patreons, because Patreons are here live, they can see us, they can see our beautiful faces, as Joe likes to say, Joe is actually in studio with Chris today.
It's true. We are... He's here in the flesh. He came up to New Jersey and
we are recording live together.
Man, it's pretty awesome, actually.
Yeah. They're interlocking fingers right now.
We are under the camera. So, we keep the PDA off the screen.
I'm going to be professional.
Yeah.
So today we're going to be doing the history on zombies. And I threw out the idea. Well, originally, I'm not sure if you guys know this. I want to do Flight of the Navigator, right?
Yeah, I knew that.
Scott from the No New Friends, that's like his favorite, one of his favorite movies. And
he's a lot of favorite movies.
He does. Flight of the Navigator I wouldn't say it's a very popular movie, right?
Really?
I think it was pretty popular, but it has a lot of history behind it. And Scott was like really excited to go ahead and share some of the history that he knows about it. And so, Scott was just recently on, and I know that I knew I was gonna be in New Jersey this week. So we kind of switched the Flight of the Navigator. So we're not gonna do Flight of the Navigator, we're gonna do Zombies. And I was real excited about Zombies because I know like this is one of Alex's like favorite movies, like Disney movies, is Zombies.
Yeah.
But what happened when you started doing the history for it, Alex?
You know, there's not a lot of history about it.
Yeah,
that's what I found out.
With such an iconic movie like Zombies, I'm really surprised you didn't find a lot.
I think the issue is it's so new, it hasn't hit that threshold of,
you know what?
Yeah, it's of probably, needing a lot of information based on it. Give me 10 years and I bet you there'll be a bunch of information regarding Zombies.
What year did Zombies come out?
You know, we'll go over it in the history, but it was 2018.
It actually came out 2 months ago. They made three of them already. So.
Disney works fast.
Well, your kids like love this movie. Like,
yes.
You know, your daughter had a Zombies birthday party.
She did.
Right?
Yep.
Yeah. So I figured that you'd be really excited about doing history on Zombies.
Oh, I was very excited doing history on Zombies until I found out there was no history to do. So,
but there's some history on it.
There's
obviously.
Some history.
You know, we got some good history here.
I made it work. And you got some synopsis. So I told you guys we'll do either A, Zombies, the first movie, or B, Zombies, the trilogy. And we're going to do Zombies, the trilogy.
Can't wait. Oh, Alex, just out of curiosity. You know the movie Black Panther?
Yes.
Do you think we could do a history on that in the future?
Is it Disney?
Yeah.
Black Panther?
Yeah, it came out.
Oh.
Like the movie, the Marvel movie?
Yeah.
I was thinking Pink Panther.
Ryan in chat, and he's saying, new Ryan, because we have a couple of Ryans, is saying that next week we should do a history on Cosmic Rewind.
Thor 4.
The new Thor movie?
I was just curious about Black Panther because that came out only a few years ago. I'm sure there's not a lot of history on it.
This came out a few years ago.
Yeah, it came out the same year as Zombies 1.
Did it actually. Really?
Mm-hmm. Sure.
Well, it was 4 years ago, right?
Sure did. Mm-hmm.
Which sure is did. Kind of a long time.
Kind of a long time.
Well, I think there will be a lot of history on that one because it's such a large media presence when it comes to Marvel.
You trying to say because it's good, Alex?
No, I'm trying to say because, you know, different people, you know, not a lot of tweeners are looking up history on Zombies, so it's not out there. But give them 10 more years and they'll be Googling that stuff on a regular basis.
We're going to do a 10-year anniversary of the Zombies episode in 10 years from now.
Even when I'm doing Dude, this that'd
be,
show?
That'd be fun to do a 10-year anniversary of like an episode to see if we could do the episode better.
We'll do it for Zombies. Mark it down. Mark Alexa, it down. Remind me in 10 years to do an episode on Zombies.
What's the reminder for?
To do an episode on Zombies 10 years from now.
Dreaming of a Disney vacation? If you aren't able to go enjoy the resorts, then get yourself some 3 Cheeky Chicks wax melts. Studies show smells help bring forward memories, so these smells are a must-have if you want to put yourself back at these grand resorts. Go to MagicallyScented.com to order scents like Animal Kingdom Lodge. It's an earthy smell with sage, lemon, and lime. There is a Port Orleans French Quarter, which has fragrance of flowers, cotton, mandarin blossoms, freesia, and peonies. The Wilderness Lodge melt smells of mahogany, blood orange, red pepper, sage, cognac, bourbon vanilla, golden amber, tonka bean, and sandalwood. The Vero Beach melt will transport you with its orange blossom, star jasmine, velvet roses, and greens. Just visit MagicallyScented.com and use promo code DizHiz20 to purchase a wide range of wax melts, candles, and room sprays, all made by 3 Cheeky Chicks. That's 3 Cheeky Chicks at MagicallyScented.com, promo code DizHiz20. That's 3 Cheeky Chicks at MagicallyScented.com. Check us out on Weeby Geeks, a new podcast website where you can find all your favorite geeky content. Just head over to WeebyGeeksPC.com. That's WeebyGeeksPC.com and listen to all the other awesome podcasts as well as Diz Hiz.
Hey, I'm Joe from the Diz Hiz.
And I'm Nick from Sandpiper Vacations.
We will be teaming up to give one of the best travel experiences ever.
I am a travel agent with Sandpiper Vacations. We are able to book any vacation destination around the world, including Disney, cruises, and all-inclusive resorts.
We have been working here at the Diz Hiz to become travel agents. And with our knowledge of the parks, we want to plan the best Disney trip for you.
Using us as a travel agent, we are updated on the latest and greatest information about all of the destinations. We can help save you time, stress, and sometimes some money. Using our services costs you absolutely nothing. It is completely free to you, and we are happy to assist you with giving you more value for your trip.
So if you're looking to book your next Disney trip, go to DizHiz.com. Check out Diz Hiz Destinations on the very top. Let's get to the Hiz on Zombies. So bad on this side of the tracks, we make it work with a little bit of swag. On this side, we can all keep winning if we just try to fit in.
Zombies is a Disney trilogy about the love story of a zombie and a cheerleader. Zombies aired on the Disney Channel in 2018 and was followed by Zombies 2 and 3, released on Disney Plus in 2020 and 2022. This musical teen drama, with a hint of comedy, had the soundtrack from the first film achieve a high Billboard chart placement. Zombies have produced a lot of merchandise and have announced a summer stage show for Disneyland and Disney World and a future animated series.
So when this first, like Alex was, he watched it first and he really liked it. I was kind of like, I'm not sure how I feel about it.
Mm-hmm.
I actually really enjoyed the zombie. Like, I enjoyed the first two movies. I haven't watched the third one yet. I really enjoyed the first two movies. So did my family. They really enjoyed it too.
Yeah.
My son, like, you know, he really likes it. But Chris, I think you have a different experience.
Well, Alex, I'm glad in the intro here you put with a hint of comedy, because that's exactly what I had, a hint of comedy. Or maybe they were hinting at trying to be funny. I'm not sure.
What'd you want, man?
I'll tell you what, the opening sequence, like the first 45 seconds of the cartoon showing how the zombies start, like, wow, this is actually, you know, not what I thought it was going to be, and like in a good way. And 25 minutes in, I'm like, this movie has to be almost over, because it just felt like it, like an hour at that point. And I was only 25 minutes in. And I was like, I just can't do this, because first of all, I thought it was a movie. I had no idea it was a musical. When they started, like when the zombie started singing a song and like, oh my gosh. Oh, he started rapping. It was the girl that started singing and he started rapping. I was like, okay, this is just not something I can get down with. Listen, if I am 27 years old, if I was 7 years old, I think I would have loved this movie, because it wasn't bad. It just was not something that holds my attention. Like it was just, I could see why a little kid would like it. And I could see why a parent would like it, because as I talked to with Alex, when you have kids, you lose like a lot of taste in movies. Like you just like garbage. And I could see why a parent would really like this movie. And the message was really good too. I didn't need to watch the end of the movie to know what was going to happen.
What kind of message?
Segregation, like they were segregated, yeah, and then they were all brought together. It was blatantly, like, I could have just watched a civil rights movie and it would have been the same thing. I could see why someone would like this movie.
Yeah,
if you don't have high expectations. Yes, exactly. That's why, like, for me, it just was not. I couldn't do it. I couldn't. Emily's making fun of me the whole time. She's making dinner in there. She's like, "What are you watching?
Did you like any of the music?"
No,
it's catchy.
Why would I like the music? If I had a kid and I was playing it for them, yeah, maybe I'd like it.
Okay, Chris, you said that because we're parents, we have bad taste. I don't think that's true. Like, do you like musicals?
Yeah.
Okay, so you liked. Let's name some musicals. I'm blanking right now for some reason.
Hamilton.
Okay, name older musicals.
Oh, I don't like
Hairspray. Abra. Did you like Hairspray?
No.
Did you like the one Grease? John Travolta? Yeah, Grease.
Hate that movie.
See, you don't like musicals.
So he doesn't like musicals.
You don't like musicals.
No, I do. I do.
What musicals do you like?
Which ones do you like?
I like good ones. In the Heights.
Which one? Okay.
In the Heights was terrible.
It wasn't that good.
What?
It wasn't that good.
In the Heights was so terrible.
It's because you're not cultured.
Did you like, here you go, people are saying, do you like Wizard of Oz?
Yes.
Sweeney Todd.
Sweeney Todd's great.
Encanto.
Wizard of Oz is not a musical.
It's not really a musical, no. It has music, but it's not
Sweeney
a musical.
I love Sweeney Todd.
I know.
Todd.
You do? No, they sing.
Don't... Sweeney Todd is Johnny Depp.
Johnny Depp, yeah. And, how about Singing in the Rain? Do you like Singing in the Rain?
Never saw that one.
Okay, it's all right. Here we go. Do you like Little Shop of Horrors?
Never saw it.
Okay, so...
But I like that song. Let's do the something, okay. Something.
That's not
like
Little Shop of Horrors, by the way.
Okay. That is Time Warp.
Rocky Horror Picture Show.
Oh, I didn't see that one either.
Oh, my gosh. Someone says Cry Baby. Great movie, again.
That's what Johnny Depp, right?
Yeah, Johnny Depp. So, Chris doesn't like musicals, is what I'm finding out. So of course I do. He's not gonna,
why would you put this up there with Sweeney Todd?
I'm not saying it's up there with him. I'm saying on the scale of musicals, you don't like musicals. So of course you're not going to like a musical.
I just named like five musicals that I did like. The other five of which I didn't even see.
Right.
Listen, I enjoy musicals, but I enjoy good musicals. I don't enjoy kid zombie musicals. I just don't. I did like the guy that was captain of the cheer team.
Bucky.
He was great.
Bucky is amazing.
Oh, who was like the huge, like huge meme?
Yes.
Like
Bucky is amazing.
Huge Bucky guy and huge coach guy.
Yeah, Coach was amazing too.
Yeah.
I love Coach. Yeah. Hey, you know what we should probably do? We should probably get into the history.
Let's do it.
I think we're about done, actually.
Let's go to his on zombies.
David Light and Joseph Rasso both attended Columbia together and formed a friendship and continued that friendship as they both wrote for the animated series Yu-Gi-Oh! They would go on to create, write, and sell numerous comedy pilots to networks like NBC, ABC, Nickelodeon, and Disney. Together, they have received many industry awards for their writing and short films. David and Joseph wrote a pilot named Zombies and Cheerleaders that was purchased by Disney. The pilot was executive produced by Eric Weinberg from Scrubs and directed by Todd Strauss from A Very Harold and Kumar 3D Christmas. The pilot was a music-driven sitcom that followed Zed Necrodopolis, played by Luke Binward, the star of How to Eat Fried Worms. Zombies wear a watch called a Z-Pack, which neutralizes their aggressive behavior. Zed and his fellow zombies start at the human high school and have to overcome being treated as second-class students. Zed falls in love with a cheerleader human named Addison, who has a very protective older cousin named Bucky, who is the captain of the cheer squad. Addison and Bucky are played by Maya Mitchell and John DeLuca, both known for Teen Beach Movie and Teen Beach Movie 2. Luke Binward told Teen Vogue in 2019 that the show had a Ferris Bueller vibe, and it was a very different kind of show that he was proud to be a part of. The pilot was filmed in 2011, but was never aired. Much like many Disney ideas, things may get shelved but can easily come back to the surface, and that is what happened to Zombies and Cheerleaders. Disney decided to turn the pilot David and Joseph wrote into a TV movie. Disney brought in Paul Hoan to direct the film. He studied at Santa Clara and had won two Directors Guild of America awards. Hoan directed TV shows like Sabrina the Teenage Witch, The Secret Life of Alex Mack, Even Stevens, Ned the Classified School Survival Guide, and Jonas. He also directed Disney movies like Luck of the Irish, Jump In, The Cheetah Girls, One World, and Eddie's Million Dollar Cook-Off. Both Jump In and Luck of the Irish were Disney Channel's highest rated first airings. Disney also hired George S. Clinton to compose the music for the musical. He wrote music for movies like Cheech and Chong Still Smoking, Mortal Kombat, and the Austin Powers series.
So it's kind of a lot of history.
Yeah, all those movies actually won Grammys, right? For best song, best original songs for those movies. So they hired a really top-notch guy to write the music for this series. Austin Powers, Cheech and Chong. Those are some of my favorite songs are from those movies.
Hold on one second. George Clinton, isn't he an NBA Jam?
I think he was president. Back in the
That's why this is George S. Clinton.
I like how the name was Zombies and Cheerleaders, and somebody was like, no, just zombies.
Just zombies.
The zombie's a bad name. That's not a good name for the movie.
No, it's not. It's really, and that's another thing. It's hard to Google zombies and come up with good stuff because you get all this other stuff that's zombies. But like they said in chat, they said, no, it's Z-O-M-B-I-E-S is actually the name, but no one calls it that. It's just zombies.
Yeah. I did like the endorsement of using steroids in the football game when they're like, you're not good enough. Use some performance enhancement Z-Pack.
Yeah, because he messes with his Z-band to become stronger.
Okay, guys. So let's talk about Hoan, right? Hoan, the director.
Yeah.
One of the directors.
Uh-huh.
He directed like a bunch of really good
TV
shows.
Oh, yes,
shows.
He did. A bunch of great TV shows.
True.
Yes.
I don't understand why if they wanted to disguise themselves, why didn't they just dye their green hair?
It's not about disguising. First off, we're not even in the history of the first movie, right? No, we're not even into the history of the first movie. We're not even to the synopsis of the first movie yet.
This is a lot of history.
But they weren't trying to disguise themselves.
No, but they could have.
No, they can't because they got to wear these watches.
You can't wear long sleeves in Zombieland?
Can you imagine if they had the watches in Walking Dead?
Yeah.
There's the last like two episodes. Just give someone a watch. They can go shopping at the mall, get a watch, and then they're not a zombie anymore.
Exactly. Yeah. But I was very surprised when I found out it was a TV show with a pilot. Like, I was very surprised. And
you
then I
watched the pilot?
No, I didn't watch the pilot. I don't think I could find it. And then I was also very surprised that Maya Mitchell and John DeLuca is in it because I love Teen Beach Movie. It is hilarious. It is hilarious. You know,
can we do the history on that next week?
Please do.
Dude, let's
this
do it.
This might be my last episode.
And it's weird. They only have two movies because the second one was kind of bad. But the first one is
what, Teen
amazing.
Beach Movie?
Yeah.
Oh, it is?
Yeah, they only have two of them. The second one's kind of bad.
Is that the movie with, what's his name in it? Zac Efron?
No.
Oh, okay.
With a skilled team to help bring the movie to life, production for the now-titled Zombies began in May of 2017. The film was shot in Toronto within 10 weeks. The movie still follows Zed the Zombie as he embarks on his high school story, but now Zed is played by Milo Mannheim. Zombies in the movie are depicted with pale skin and green hair. Milo's mother is actress Cameron Mannheim, known for the TV series The Practice and Ghost Whisperer. He started acting at age 6 and has starred in over 20 musicals. Zombies was his first big role, which led to him guest starring on The Conners and participating in the season 27 of Dancing with the Stars. While at school, Zed falls in love with a new cheerleader named Addison, who hides her white hair. Addison is played by Meg Donnelly, who starred in the TV series American Housewife. In the movie adaptation, Zed gets help from his friend Eliza, played by Kylie Russell, to hack his Z-band, which keeps zombies from going berserk, so he can play football. Zed uses his football fame to help zombies receive every opportunity their human counterparts get. Other notable characters are Bucky, played by Trevor Tordham, Bree, played by Carla Jeffrey, and Bonzo, played by James Godfrey. When Zombies premiered in February of 2018, it received over 2.5 million views. Over the weekend of its premiere, it had reached almost 13 million viewers. The Zombies soundtrack became a hit, peaking at number 4 for Billboard's top-selling children's music titles. In February of 2019, Disney announced a sequel to Zombies named Zombies 2, which will bring back the crew and actors.
So, Alex, do you like Zombies 2?
Yes, I do like Zombies 2.
Do you like it better than the first one?
You know what? I don't know. They're both very good.
Okay. Did you watch the second one, Chris?
No.
He
didn't really watch the first one. He turned the first one after 25 minutes. When the kids started rapping, he's like, I'm out.
No, it wasn't that. I watched 25 minutes. They talked about football, and then he wasn't playing. And I was like, all right, it's got to fast forward to the football scene. The football scene was great.
It was okay.
Because they're getting destroyed. And then it's like, boop, 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 to his band. And then he started destroying everybody.
Yeah, because he went all feral.
But I just love in the middle of they're down 22-0 at halftime. The principal comes in. She goes, you're not holding up your end of the deal.
Yeah. Well, yeah, because he made a deal back that if they do well, the kids can eat in the cafeteria. The zombies can eat in the cafeteria. The movie is very about separation and people becoming one community.
It's a good message. Yeah, for sure. Oh, great message, for sure. I did appreciate the message they were sending that we should look at zombies as human beings because they're just like us. They're just green hair and pale skin.
Yeah, and if their watch goes awry, they will eat you.
That is true too. So don't trust them.
But you know what position Zed played on the football field?
Fullback.
Fullback. Like he played fullback. You would think he played halfback, right, Chris?
Yeah, it's weird.
Yeah,
no, he played fullback position anymore, right?
Barely.
It is in the league, but yeah, there's like one person who plays fullback. He played fullback, and it seemed like he was playing running back.
Do we know how long these people have been zombies for? It hasn't been long, right? A couple of years.
I think. I think Zed is a second generation zombie.
A second generation, because I was wondering why they had names like Zed and Bonzo if they were born human beings and turned zombies.
Yeah, they all have Z's in their name. And I was telling Christina this the other day. I go, they all have Z's in their name. She's like, what? I was like, yeah, Eliza, Bonzo, Zed, Zoe. She's like, I never noticed that. I was like, for real? You never noticed that?
Why would they all have Z's in their name?
Because they're zombies.
Clever.
Which brings up another good point. In the second movie, zombies are now part of the community. But they
you
still
really
call
this movie, man.
Spoiler
like,
alert.
Really
they still
movie.
Call the police officers Z Patrol.
That's pretty zombieist.
Right. That's pretty messed up to call still have your police officers named Z Patrol, even though zombies are supposed to be just like us.
This did remind me of World War II, because in the beginning when they had to wear the special uniforms and everything, I thought that was kind of cool that they were, I don't know. I like the it's kind of teaching World War II and the Holocaust without teaching the Holocaust like to little kids. So I thought that was kind of cool.
And I love the style of zombies, how they're very they recycle and they use everything over and make these different kind of machines with old things, and they repurpose clothing. All their clothing have patches all over it, and they're using different kind of things. Another thing about Milo Mannheim, you might have asked, hey, he was in Dancing with Stars season 27. How do you do? Well, actually, surprisingly, a kid who grew up in you know, musicals, dancing and singing, was a runner up that season.
Wow. That's pretty impressive.
That's pretty cool.
Speaking of the just the characteristics of these people, I did laugh very hard at the, not very hard, but as hard as I did the whole time, at the cauliflower brains.
Did you?
Oh, yes.
No, it was the beginning. It was the beginning. Sure? Yeah,
yeah, the beginning. They have breakfast.
You laughed
yeah.
a lot?
Huh?
Why did you watch the whole thing? You laughed.
No, oh, that was the one thing that I laughed at.
Did you hear the line where he said, cheer's very contagious. Yeah, so was pink eye.
Yeah, I did hear that. Didn't laugh.
Oh.
Sorry.
So was what?
Pink eye.
Oh.
That was the little girl said
funny.
That.
That's funny.
I didn't like that girl. She was annoying. The little sister was annoying.
Zoe?
I don't know the name. She was a little girl and she hacked the band.
Oh, that's Eliza.
Yeah, she said that so is Pink Eye.
Yes,
sure.
She's very antisocial.
I would have watched a whole movie on Bucky.
Bucky's amazing.
They should do a whole movie on him.
Bucky was great. I loved when he jumped through the sign
yeah.
of him.
Uh-huh.
And there was a sign of him behind the sign of him. And then he came out doing the pose.
Yeah, that was amazing.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's a great character. He's a great. He's a very funny actor.
I'm glad you rephrased "great actor" to "very funny actor."
Great actor is a little much.
Yeah, too many times he breaks Joe's top 20 favorite actors.
Mind the system then about that in chat.
The cast grew in size with the arrival of Pierce Jose, Chandler Kinney, and Ariel Martin joining as the werewolves. Errol Martin was the biggest name to join the cast with millions of social media followers. Production started in May of 2019 in Toronto and wrapped up by July. Zombies 2 joins Zed and Addison a year later as they are openly the powerhouse couple of Seabrook High School. Things are great until the arrival of a werewolf pack. Each werewolf has their own style, but they all share a form of white hair strands paired with large canines. Addison reveals her white hair, thinking she may be a werewolf. During the premiere on February 14, 2020, it reached almost 2.5 million viewers. The sequel performed better than the original, with young adults between the ages of 18 and 49. It was as quickly as October of 2020 an animated short premiered named Addison's Moonstone Mystery, which was continued in 2021 as Addison's Monster Mystery. The second movie continued the ideals of the first movie, allow everyone to be who they are and unite to build a stronger community. Zed and Addison helped the city of Seabrook accept all walks of life, which in turn helped Seabrook become a better high school and city. In the footsteps of High School Musical and Descendants, Disney had to make a third movie for the Zombies franchise. In March of 2021, Disney announced Zombies 3. Filming continued in Toronto, beginning in May of 2021. The cast was joined by Matt Cornet, Kyra Tenteo, and Terry Hu, as the new group entering Seabrook, Aliens. Zed and Addison and company are all looking forward to graduation as Seabrook is now a melting pot of humans, zombies, and werewolves, with the three different groups mixing throughout all of town and high school life. The aliens stand out due to their blue hair and arrive during a severe storm brought on by their ship. The aliens covertly look for the missing coordination to a new home, and eventually, the aliens and Addison realize her DNA possesses the missing coordinates because she is part alien. Addison changes to having blue hair and leaves with the aliens to find their utopia. But of course, utopia was on Earth all along, so the aliens return just in time for the high school's graduation. Zombies 3 premiered on Disney Plus on July 15th, 2022.
So Addison, I mean, she's just trying to find herself.
That's right. Yeah, she's just trying to figure out who she is.
Wait, who's Addison? Is she the cheerleader?
Yeah.
She is the
white hair?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
She's part alien?
Yes.
Yeah, man.
And you know, she just leaves with them?
And you know what the messed up thing is? Is when she reveals this to everybody, her mom's like, yes, I'm part alien too. And she pulls off her wig and has white hair. And her husband's shocked. And I go, her husband never knew she wore a wig? And also, what a terrible mother. You're letting your daughter grow up. Having white hair, having to wear a wig, for thinking she's a weird person when you also have white hair. You could have confided into each other, but no, you're going to wait till she's a senior in high school to reveal, yes, I am also have white hair and we are weird.
She has to wait. She had to wait until she was like old enough to handle that type of information, right? Because she thought she was human at first.
Okay,
then she thought she was a werewolf.
But she could have been
thought
like,
she was an alien.
But she could have been also have white hair. That's where you get it from. So it's not so weird. She didn't have to reveal the alien.
But in a lot of these movies, they usually like, you know, what's the Onward, right?
Yes.
Like they didn't like, you have to hit a certain age before you can kind of know this information for the movie.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. It's
it would be a really bad movie if she was like three and they're like, oh, listen, I'm an alien.
Like
it's not good.
Like you have to sit down and read a book with her about aliens, you know,
good.
Right?
Not good. Also, I didn't love this movie. But I do respect the franchise. They just keep recycling the same movie, but with different races of creatures.
Uh-huh.
and people eat it up. Next, yes. We'll do, I don't know, what are the next? Mutants? Robots, maybe?
Yeah.
Okay, so.
Superheroes?
So, I actually did not like Zombies 3.
Really?
Not? It's not that great. The music doesn't hit like Zombies 1 and 2. It's written by the same person.
It's all the original cast, right?
It's all the original cast, including three more, because they have to add the aliens. And the new cast members do well, and then they have special people in the movie, and it continues the story.
Special people in the movie?
We'll get to it in the Hiz. And Bucky comes back and all that stuff. And, you know, it had some funny moments. It had some good times, but it's not as good as 1 and 2.
So hold on. So what else didn't you like about it?
Oh, that's it. The music didn't hit as good as 1 and 2. The story was not great. The whole Addison becoming a alien, then leaving, and then they come right back. You know, it was kind of, I don't know if it was predictable, but it just wasn't as good as 1 and 2. You let me know how you feel when you see it, Joe.
Okay.
Thank you for not asking me to.
I know you won't watch it.
No, I appreciate it. In 15 years, when I have a kid that's of age, I'll let you know then.
You can't wait.
Zombies like 14 will probably be out by then.
No, because the next history, you'll know what else is coming.
Oh,
with the success of Zombies 1 and 2 and the potential success of Zombies 3, it is no surprise that Disney has already announced Zombies, the reanimated series. The series will bring guests into the daily lives of the Seabrook crew as a gang survives high school. The town is bursting with a variety of creatures, now adding vampires, aliens, and even mermaids. President of Disney Branded Television said the new series will help represent the very best Disney has to offer, with the animation and incredible storytelling. The new series will premiere on Disney Plus in 2023. Disney also announced a stage show named Zombeats. This 20-minute performance will feature music from all three movies with amazing choreography. The show will premiere at Disneyland at the Downtown Disney Live stage on July 29th and run until the 31st. It will then head to Disney World, performed on the Disney Springs Advent Health Waterside stage from August 5th through the 14th.
It's not Downtown Disney at Disneyland. Okay.
So they have a new animated series coming out, which is exactly what you guys talk about, different creatures. They had vampires in a short last year, and they have red hair, by the way, if you're just curious. And now in the animated series.
Did you watch it?
I don't know if I saw it or not. I don't know if I watched it while Emma was watching it. And then, of course, in the animated series, at the end of 3, they show the city expanding with all these different creatures coming in. And they show mermaids and other mythical creatures joining Seabrook.
I think it's cool that they're going to have an animated series. I mean, they have the Disney Plus. It's like a perfect place to put it. So
mm-hmm. It's a good idea for the direction of the show. Absolutely not. But I'm happy for anybody who enjoys
it. Maybe Bucky's going to be in it, though.
If Bucky's a main character, I might.
I also heard they're going to do, like, you know, like Olaf has his shorts.
Yeah.
They're going to do Bucky shorts. Forky, right? They have a Bucky series coming out.
You know what? At the end of the Zombies 3, Bucky is also part alien because he is Addison's cousin. And so he gets into the spacecraft and he says he's going to explore the space and he flies off in the spacecraft.
Like Han Solo?
Maybe there's going to be a Bucky spinoff where he's flying around teaching cheer to the different species.
Oh,
I'll help fund it. Man. Yeah, I'll help fund
it. That's not a bad idea. Kind of give a good way to kind of, you know, show other alien species that Earth is okay. Just teach them like cheers.
That's right.
And they come here and we take them over.
Even though Bucky was, even though Bucky's the villain of number 1 and 2.
Is he not in 3 though? He changed his ways.
He's right. Like Loki.
Well, actually, in 3, Loki. He's the villain. Like he's also the villain in 3, actually.
But he's kind of like Loki, though.
Yeah, Loki
like,
got his own
show.
Is he
a bad guy? Is he a good guy?
Yeah.
You know?
Because he antagonizes Zed when he's a zombie, knowing Zed's not going to eat him to get him arrested when he's going off the rails.
Oh, calm down. Spoilers.
Yeah, spoiler alert, dude. I didn't know that.
Yeah.
So, he's got a record.
So before we quickfire quick facts and outro, I have a little thing to play you guys.
Oh. Okay.
I'm excited.
Okay, so I have a special guest here, my daughter. And daughter, what is your name?
Emma.
And how old are you?
I'm 5.
You love Disney, is this correct?
Yes.
Okay. And do you love the movies Zombies?
Yes, because I really, really like Zombies.
So if you had to pick between the three movies, which one would your favorite be?
I would choose Zombies 3.
Zombies 3 is your favorite out of all three?
Yeah, it's just because I like Addison. That's why I just like it. So
you like Zombies 3 because Addison, her hair turns blue.
Yes,
that's and you think pretty. That's pretty.
That's really pretty.
So when it comes,
she's like prettier than the other aliens.
Okay. And when it comes to music, which one is your favorite song?
Zombies 3. The Zombies 3 one.
Which Zombies 3 song are you talking about?
The first one.
The first one? The Under Attack? Mm-hmm. All right. So that is your favorite song from Zombies 3? Mm-hmm. Okay. So now, you know, we watched it as a family when we came back from our vacation. We made sure to watch it. Like, it was like right after it came out.
Yeah.
And I'm a big Zombies fan.
Mm-hmm. And me too.
You're a big zombie. Mommy's a big Zombies fan. Link's a Zombies fan.
And me too.
And you too. And now I would say the best Zombies song would be from the first movie. Now I think Someday is one of the best songs.
It's not the best song to me.
You don't think this is the best song?
Mm-hmm.
But I mean, it tells a story. You don't think that's the best song?
It doesn't even tell a story.
I know we might be crazy, but did you hear the story?
Yeah, I think I heard it.
So how about Bam?
That's my favorite one, too. Welcome to Zombieland. That's my favorite one, too.
This is also your favorite song?
Yeah.
Okay, so this is also your favorite song. Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay, so then how about this song from Zombies 2? This is a great one. Do
it like this. Yeah, I like that one, too. I like that one too.
Okay, so if you had to pick a favorite song, what would it be?
All three of them.
You can't pick all three. You have to pick one.
I just wanted to pick all three.
Okay, so who's your favorite Zombies character?
Oh, I definitely know that.
And okay, so who is it?
Eliza.
Eliza is your favorite Zombies character?
Yeah, because I just wear it on Halloween when I was like, when did I do that when I was?
I think you were three because your brother was one, I think. So you were Eliza for Halloween. I'll put the pictures in Discord. And Eliza's being played by Kylie Russell. Who's your second favorite character?
I need to say Zoe.
Zoe is your second favorite character?
Yeah.
And Zoe is Zed's little sister, right? Okay. All right. Now, if you had to tell everyone why they should go watch Zombies, what would you say to them?
The music and, like, everything else.
Okay, so the music and the actors, the characters.
Uh-huh, and everything else.
Mm-hmm. Well, you heard it here first. Zombies 1, 2, and 3, the series, is amazing because the songs and everything else.
That was cool.
Well, that was amazing.
Yeah, we did that today.
That was awesome.
Because he's like, you should do the thing with Emma because she loves it so much. And I was like, oh, yeah, just see what happens.
I was so afraid you were just going to play a song. I'm like, oh, no. And then I heard Emma, and it was amazing.
So like a jerk right now.
Oh, I think I love zombies now.
Oh, good. Good. Yeah, I asked her, I said, what would you say to somebody who said they didn't like zombies, like Chris? And she's like, he should like it.
Well, tell her I like it now.
Okay. So we have some quick fire effects. And unfortunately, I couldn't find a lot of quick fire effects. So we have four. Thinking there was going to be four hosts today, but unfortunately, Jen couldn't join us. She got tied up in other things.
Is she no longer with us, like me?
Quick fire, quick facts. Let's go.
Joseph Rezo and David Light sold a story idea to Larry David's Curb Your Enthusiasm titled The Bow Tie for season 5. The episode was about the etiquette of the handicapped stall in public bathrooms.
I love that episode.
That's a good episode.
Yeah. RuPaul voices the mothership in Zombies 3.
There you go. There was the other people in the movie, RuPaul. They were the big reveal of a celebrity that was in
the
movie.
That's funny. RuPaul's awesome.
Kylie Russell was not on set with the other actors due to being pregnant and giving birth. Her shots were only torso up with a robot representing her in parts of the movie. And that was in Zombies 3. We were watching and we're like, why is she not there? She was only chest up. She was only head if she was on a video screen or she was on a robot. We're like, what is going on? Maybe she didn't get vaccinated mm-hmm. and so she couldn't be there. No, she was pregnant and then she actually gave birth while they were filming.
Who is Kylie Russell? Who does she play?
Eliza, which is my daughter's favorite.
Oh, okay, I see.
Yep. Zombies was the number one movie on Disney Now for over 3 weeks.
We here at Diz Hiz think Zombies was a fun series. The movie brought forth a great message of acceptance paired with some great songs. We look forward to seeing how Disney incorporates zombies into the parks and the future zombie animated series. Now, I don't know what to put sometimes in the outro. And I know we always have fun with me saying like, oh, we here at Diz Hiz love this. And then if they listen back to episode, it's clearly we don't love it. I did say that can't wait for them to get zombies in the parks. They don't have Descendants in the parks. And I think Descendants is a lot better than zombies. So I really don't think zombies is going to be in the parks, even though they are doing the stage show.
Yeah, I was going to say, you mentioned that.
So, I mean, that's cool, but I don't think it's going to be a long-lasting effect in the parks.
Also, Alex, for saying you didn't find a lot of stuff, you really stretched whatever you found. Like, it was a lot of, like, it didn't seem that way. If you never said anything, I wouldn't have thought it.
Oh, yeah. Well, a lot of that, like I said, a lot of it's synopsis. And
yeah, but that's fine. Because a lot of people probably haven't watched this movie. So the synopsis is good. Like, it wasn't, like, repeating what everybody knows, you know?
Yeah. Which I need to know. I needed no help with the synopsis.
Yeah.
Do that straight from memory.
Hey, you want to hear something really cool, Alex?
Sure do.
So let me tell you a little bit about the Goof Troop, Alex. Do you know about the Goof Troop?
I kind of do.
Well, it's a great way to support the show. You get access to our live shows, which is like a total mess.
Oh, it's a total mess. I edit it and I have to sit there and make sure it sounds professional.
Yeah, and it's not at all. We do giveaways, you know, a couple times a month. We're always giving away wax melts. We're giving away candles. You know, we're giving away books.
It's not fair because I can't be in the giveaways because I'm a host.
I always try to get in the giveaways, but yeah, it's really not right if I join in, right?
No.
But you can support us for as low as $2 a month, and you can get access to all of these things.
Just for $2?
Yeah, just for $2.
Wow.
In our Discord chat, our Discord chat is off the chain. It is awesome. It's a lot of fun. We have made lifelong friends in our Discord chat.
It's bumping, as the kids would say.
It is bumping, as the kids are saying. And you can, we have a bunch of great Patreon members that keep our chat super active. There's so many great members that I look forward to every morning to wake up and to talk to every day.
So where do you join this Patreon?
So, good question there, Alex. All you have to do is go to dizhiz.com, dizhiz.com. On the very top, there's a Goof Troop link. Just hit the Goof Troop link. Takes you to our Patreon, and there's so many different ways you can support our show.
And as low as $2 a month.
As low as $2 a month. And it helps us keep our website up. It helps us with advertising, you know? So for as low as $2 a month, you can help support our show. You can help us advertise, get our show out there to more people so they can listen. And so because we love to interact with fans. We love interacting with everyone. So go ahead and join our Discord.
Check us out streaming on award-winning Disney streaming site Sorcerer Radio on Fridays at 1 p.m. Eastern Time, or catch us again at 8 p.m. Eastern Time. Sorcerer Radio is an amazing 24/7 Disney radio. Just visit srsounds.com or download the Sorcerer Radio app.
This week in the world of Disney / news, I haven't been doing that much because I've been driving all over the place.
Yes, you have.
I've been in Georgia for a week. I'm in New Jersey in the Poconos for a week. And then we're going to be hitting DC for a couple of days. So I really haven't been doing a lot except for kind of enjoying the outside wilderness, I guess you can say. So I haven't done anything. How about you, Alex?
I have also not done very much since the last episode because I was in Georgia with you enjoying the creek life. Which I didn't know I liked creeks. I didn't know I liked going in creeks and hanging out in the water. Not a big beach guy, even though we live very close to it here in Daytona Beach. But the creek was nice. But
I'm the same way, Alex.
You're the same
way?
I'm
a creeks over creeks and lakes over beach guy for sure.
Yeah. I've never been to like a lake where I can go out and swim and stuff. Like never done that. But yeah. But like I said earlier, when we got back from our vacation from Georgia, we got back around like 2 p.m., I think, 3 p.m., and we ordered pizza and watched Zombies 3 because everyone in the family in the house was looking forward to it. Even Emma's grandmother, Amelia, Joe's mom, she was super excited for us to get home because she was with us on vacation. She was super excited for us to get home, eat pizza, and watch Zombies 3. She was very excited about
awesome.
It.
That's awesome.
So all five of us watched Zombies 3, very excited about it. And then at night, the kids were happy about it. Me and Christine were not so much because we didn't think Zombies 3 was very good.
Okay, how about you, Chris?
Well, I have a lot to talk about because I did one thing in the week at Disney, but I have a lot of stuff to talk about regarding it. So Emily and I went to go see Thor Love and Thunder.
Ah, nice.
This was directed by Taika Waititi, and who directed Thor Ragnarok. We'll come out the gate and say Thor Ragnarok, better movie than Love and Thunder.
Okay.
Thor Ragnarok's, in my opinion, a near-perfect Marvel movie.
Near-perfect, yep.
As good as you can get without being better than the Avengers movies, right? It's up there for a single superhero
movie. Yeah, I agree. Yeah.
this one was very, very Taika Waititi. Like, it was very his type of humor, very humorous movie. I can see why people who aren't used to something like that would hate this movie, but I don't think that's a fair judgment of the movie. I thought it was a really fun movie. And that's the thing. Like, it wasn't that they were trying to be funny. It was funny. Like, it was, they were like, you were like laughing out loud. Like, it was hilarious. Kurt Russell did an awesome job as Zeus. He was hilarious in the movie. And they did some setting up for Thor moving forward for the next Thor movie. Didn't do a lot of setting up for the MCU as a whole. Now, the movie was like,
the MCU's dead.
Well, I'll talk about that. I give this movie a solid like 7 out of 10. No, it wasn't a perfect movie by any means.
7?
It wasn't perfect.
7?
Yeah, I give it like a 3.5 out of 5 stars on my movie box.
Wow.
3.5 out of 5, which is good. I mean, that's a good review. Just like, it wasn't a great movie, but it was a very, very, very fun movie. The action sequences in the movie were awesome. It was hilarious. But it was like, it was a fun, enjoyable movie. And, you know, I'm worried about the MCU slightly. I'm actually worried.
How much did we make that bet for?
Well, no, not about, not, there will be another Avengers movie in the next 5 years. $50? I don't know.
Okay. Yeah, $50.
We have it on audio.
It is on audio. Yeah. There will be another Avengers movie in the next 5 years. Okay. I'm worried. I think that this phase is overly saturated, and they're trying to pump out too many things, and they're going for quantity over quality.
Yeah.
We're seeing news articles come out about their visual effects artists being treated poorly. They're being worked to the bone, and it's actually showing. I remember when Marvel was like the Cadillac, I guess, of visual effects. Like, if you go to a Marvel movie, you know the visual effects were going to be amazing. And it's like, not even like, some scenes are bad. Like, between She-Hulk, which granted didn't come out yet, but the trailer for She-Hulk didn't even look finished.
Yeah.
It didn't even look finished. Like, it was bad, right?
Yeah.
There were some parts that even Taika Waititi was ripping apart in his own movie, in Love and Thunder, in an interview.
Hmm.
He's with the woman that plays Valkyrie. And he says, "Does this look real to you?" She's like, "Oh, no, this is bad." And it was like a finished cut of one of the scenes, which is, first of all, horrible for the director to be, you know, attacking these people. But it's not good. Between I guess She-Hulk, Moon Knight, there were some really bad visual effects scenes with the staff that, I forget if it was blue or purple. The stuff coming out of the ground looked really, really poor on some of those. Thor Ragnarok, it was. Some of the visual effects were great. Others were like really, really bad. Like, it was kind of, it was very worrisome. Now, I haven't watched Ms. Marvel yet, but I heard that Ms. Marvel is not great as far as the visual effects department goes either. It seems like it's trending towards like not being
the
best anymore.
You're right.
And I think that
we also expect that from a Disney Plus show.
That's the thing. Yeah. That's what I'm getting at, is that I'm worried that now that Disney's taken over Marvel, we're now phased out of the, what do they call it? The Infinity Saga. And now we're going into this like kids portion of the, look at all the heroes. They're all getting younger. Ms. Marvel.
I called it, man. This is what I said.
No. You said there's not going to be another Avengers movie, but there will be.
No, there's not.
Yes, there will.
With all these, like,
yeah.
All these other, no,
yes.
I don't think so.
And it's getting a little kiddish, and the MCU is kind of getting Disney-fied, and I'm a little worried about it.
So people are saying in chat, Young Avengers. So Young Avengers doesn't count as an Avengers.
No,
movie.
it'll be the Avengers.
Yes.
Like a Hulk, all of them. Mm-hmm. There's no way. No way. Nope.
So the other thing about this is the positive side of Thor Love and Thunder is I also hate how they're not really setting up much for this like next phase. Like, Loki was setting up, like, you know, they introduced the new big bad, and then he's nowhere to be found. And they had plenty of opportunities in some of these movies and shows, and he's just nowhere around yet. I don't understand they're not setting anything up for the MCU as a whole, but I guess maybe Quantumania they will. But anyway, I love the fresh take on some of these films, because every Marvel film, you have a hero, you have a bad guy, the good guy wins in the end. And it's just like an action comedy. And we've watched that for however 25 movies, you know, in phase 1 through 3. Multiverse of Madness was a borderline, like, it was like a thriller horror movie. It wasn't very funny. Mm-hmm. It was like borderline, like, scary movie.
Yeah.
this was a comedy. This was like a full-blown comedy with good action scenes, but this was way, like, they tried to be way funnier than a normal Marvel movie. And I really like how they got directors like Sam Raimi and Taika Waititi and just said, go, you know, move this, or, you know, film this movie in your vision. And they let them do that. That gives me some hope and kind of like fresh new kinds of these superheroes. Like, we, you know, that's what happens when you give these directors creative control. You have Taika Waititi totally remodeling Thor. Now Chris Hemsworth says, I'll be Thor until I die, you know? So I don't know. I'm a little worried. I'm concerned. Now, what I'm excited for this week, I think tomorrow, is Hall H, I think it is, at San Diego Comic-Con.
Who?
And Hall H, that's where Marvel's doing their presentations, and they're going to, I don't think they're going to reveal a lot, because I think they're going to save a lot for D23, but they will be announcing some stuff moving forward, some new projects, which would be kind of cool. Hopefully we get a look at maybe Wakanda Forever, maybe Fantastic Four.
I
expect a lot of this to be revealed at D23 and not San Diego Comic-Con, because, you know, mm-hmm. it's their event.
Yeah.
But that's really interesting. And before I stop talking about Marvel, I do want to say it. I think for the first time, first time in maybe ever, maybe since The Dark Knight came out, DC had a better year than Marvel.
This year?
They released Peacemaker, which was a phenomenal TV show. Right, Alex? Great TV show.
Peacemaker?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I'm sorry. Yes.
Great show.
Suicide Squad.
Suicide Squad was really good.
Yes.
Good. The Batman was really good.
It was good. So
it's like they had a really good year. And it was like, I feel like this was the, and Ryan just put in chat, Black Adam's coming out soon with The Rock.
I've been waiting for that movie for years.
So is The Rock. And they had the Zack Snyder cut, I think was this year, maybe last year, of Justice League, it was cool though. Yeah. But I just think that, I don't know. Marvel definitely had some competition this year for the first time. And I truly think since The Dark Knight came out.
But with competition comes improvement.
I hope so. Yeah. So, I would hope so.
But the thing is you mentioned, you know, Marvel might be getting too young, but Ms. Marvel, that's on Disney Plus. She-Hulk, that's on Disney Plus. They're putting these Disney Plus things out that might be lower quality because they're going on TV series. Happening, being produced quickly, being put out quickly, but those are for the younger generation. And then the movies are for the older generation. Thor Love and Thunder was a good movie. You said there were some issues with the graphic designing in it or whatever. But I think the quality of the movie, like the writing, you said it was funny. You said it was entertaining. Yeah. It's getting some mixed reviews. That's correct. Not on all Marvels get mixed reviews. I think you're getting the D plus stuff mixed up with the movie stuff. The movie is for adults. I think D plus is for the younger generation.
Could be, but I just see you have Iron Man and Captain America dying, knocks the age from what, you know, that he was 100 years old. The average age is now like 14. He's dead.
Wait, what? What'd you just say?
Captain America brought the average age up super high. But I can't really say a lot without spoiling some of Thor. So. Yeah. In a couple of weeks, when everyone watches Thor, we'll talk more about this young thing. But yeah, Spider-Man's like, you know, he's going into college. He's young. Ms. Marvel was setting up, I assume, the Marvels movie that's coming out. Mm-hmm. You know, so she's going to be
Just like comic books. That's how comic books work. Comic books, they run all these series with the original, you know, person, and then they pick up their predecessor, who is always younger, that's how the comic books usually work.
But comic books, they can bring people back to life. I mean, they'll kill off. They have the death of Captain America, and he's right back in the next one because it's comic books.
Well, they have
a bunch
of different people writing a bunch of different series,
right? Right.
Which they can do because they had the multiverse.
That's true. They can do anything
they want because they have the multiverse. The multiverse is the hack.
It is a good cop out. It is a really good cop out, and maybe that's their insurance. Maybe it's like, hey, this isn't working.
Like, ooh, we messed up. Hey, guess what? Earth 36 called. And they have an awesome Captain America.
Earth 38's having a problem with this purple bald guy looking for glowing rocks. I think we're going to have to go help him. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe that's there. Oh, and that, yes, Kate Bishop is another one that they've groomed to be, you know, in the next movie. That's just a lot of, which Kate Bishop is actually the one person that I actually really enjoyed, young person in these shows or whatever. She's actually really great. But yeah, so I'm concerned, but I'm not writing them off by any means, but definitely not used to this level of Marvel. Marvel's actually, I feel like they're not the golden standard for some of these things, for like, you know, visual effects anymore, which sucks.
Yeah.
We'll see what happens. I'm not gonna write them off. I hope they start treating their visual effects people better, then they'll get better.
Yeah, I didn't hear that part, so that kind of stinks. It's fun. I was just thinking about, you said Marvel made me think of Star Wars, and I just watched the series finale of Obi-Wan.
Very good, right?
It was a decent finale. Very short series, 6 episodes. I thought it was too short for sure. And is it confirmed there's a second season coming?
They want to make one, them being McGregor and Hayden Christensen.
Well, Hayden Christensen wants it for sure.
Yeah, so they're definitely willing. Who knows if there will be one? But if you don't look at it as a TV show, Alex, and you look at it instead as a 6-hour-long Obi-Wan movie,
yeah,
it helps a little bit.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, you're right about that. I definitely will want them to make more. And it's, they definitely left it off, and I love at the end, Qui-Gon Jinn.
That was really cool. That was really cool.
Spoiler alert.
A lot of fan service in the show, which I love.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Some of the fan service was even forced, but I didn't even care. Mm-hmm. Like I didn't even care. It was everything we needed and everyone people wanted to see.
Yeah.
Who knew we would see them fight? You know,
that was awesome.
Who knew?
Yeah.
Who knew that Leia would eventually grow up?
So that's the Hiz on Zombies. I'm Joe.
I'm Alex.
I'm Chris.
Thanks for listening and have a magical week.
Please follow us on all social media by searching DizHiz65. Share us and subscribe to our podcast to get the latest show when it is available. If you want to help us out, get tips, get your memories shared on the podcast, see pictures and videos of what we are up to at the parks, join our goof troop on patreon.com and search for DizHiz.